For we, the Knights of Britonia, will be your shield.
Hello, guys and gals, and welcome back to Total War Warhammer. I just about forgot the name of this game. Holy crap. That would have been embarrassing. So, Bordelot, the Sir Elbrick, or actually it's not Sir Elbrick, it's just Elbrick de Bordelot, would like a confederation. So I am going to accept that, and no, I don't want to pay him. I want payment. I want more payment. I want more payment. Jesus, I can take so much money from you. I'm not sure why. My guess is that they just lost their main army in some kind of something or other. Okay, so now we have Bordelot. Awesome. Unfortunately, we lost money? No, alright, that was our income. I was like, why did... No, alright, so we have money. Alright. Wow, they are almost up to rank 4. I'm actually going to demolish this one in favor of this one, because they've got that already. Cool. Wine. Yes. We'll start building up the wine. I don't want this just yet, but that was the main reason. I haven't checked all of these.
The lady grants you
so I suppose.
In these
right now, we'll just keep on checking.
Welcome
to see if
friends. Let's hope.
Anyone else. Oh, Paravon we can trade
Welcome
with.
Welcome to fair Britonia. Now is the time to unite.
Let's see. Maybe with that trade agreement, they'll bump it up high enough to where they're willing to do it. Alright. Beastman, Carrick. So I think that that's pretty good for right now. I want to get Paravon before they get swallowed up by the Argwillon or whatever the hell that's called. And I would really, really like to get these guys too, because they look like they're doing really well in their endeavors.
Devotee of the lady.
But it looks like, yeah, yep, Elbrick died.
We have met before.
Alright, well, I'll just bring this chick up to help us with the campaign up against the dwarves that we're gonna have here shortly. So that I'm saving up to buy this because it gives you a good amount of income bonus, but unfortunately we're still a turn away. But it's okay. Get that maybe later, but I just wanted to start this out. I think, you know what, I think next turn we will be attacking this, so I don't even need to cut here. Oh, alright, we want growth until we can't grow anymore. Okay, savage orcs, if you ever or remember from my Attila playthrough how there was the hordes, basically they are orc hordes that will go through. I'm positive if, yeah, we don't start at war with any of them, thankfully.
The laws of chivalry demand,
but,
I hear you.
No, I don't want a vassal, I want... Why would I ask him to be a vassal when I can just confederate
him? The laws of chivalry demand. Welcome, friends. Let's hope we can come to an accommodation.
Soon.
I am Morgiana.
You will all be part of it. You will all be part of my plan. So I think we still got, what was it, 4 turns? Now I got 3 turns left for Elbrick. He's only level 4. Let's see what... Can I not check? Okay. I can't check what his skills are right now. But,
do you know who I am?
We're gonna move...
By the light of the lady.
You. To assault.
The lady wills it!
Just encircle it for right now, because I want to bring my other armies up to get them experience and whatnot.
My lady calls.
Smite them.
Is
your coming was foretold.
Are you gonna be be able to get here. Probably not. Nope. No, you're not. That's okay. She'll be here for the second one. But it does look like, yeah, we're gonna auto-resolve this just because, quite honestly, the dwarves are a very, very good defensive faction, and, I was having troubles just assaulting the Empire, let alone the dwarves. The dwarves will give us lots of trouble, especially in cities. Out in the open, we can utilize our knights a little bit more, but in the city, we're definitely gonna... auto-resolve is gonna be our friend here. It doesn't look like we lost anybody, which is good. And it doesn't look like our main characters really lost a whole lot of health, which is also good. Might have gained a little bit of ranks, nice. They gained a rank, okay. That's not too bad. A little bit of chivalry too. We want to raise.
Cleanse our land.
Okay, so now our... which one is it? This chick, she now causes fear. And terror.
I serve the lady.
Cool. I think the only one that leveled up was Louis. It's fine. We want the lady's champion. Awesome. You will now be able to level up a little bit. We got a little bit more chivalry going. Let's check. We are now able to... oh, they added that money. So we're able to buy the port. And let's upgrade Marienburg as long as we're here. We have 500 left over. Is that enough to do anything else? Does not appear to be so. Cool. Sounds good. I think we already checked all of them for a alliance or whatever. Still a level... oh, girl. Warhorse? I think I'm gonna give a horse so she can move faster and I can use her to dodge stuff when we're doing assaults on cities and whatnot. So, end the turn here. Unfortunately, from this point on, it's gonna be a whole lot of auto resolve stuff. It's not going to be a whole lot of us actually going out and fighting the battles. So, do the same thing. She's not going to be able to make it. Interesting. I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to continue this siege. We're not gonna actually fight this one this turn.
My strength and wisdom are yours.
And we're just gonna.
I go hence.
Get within range. That way, the next turn I can bring
my magic
her
is
in
yours.
And get her a little bit of experience. Great, the wine market. I believe that ends up making us a good amount of money. Well, it's 144 barrels of wine, which. Let's see here, is it treasury, trade, wine, income of 680, that's not bad. Beer is a little bit more expensive. And these are all affected by how much there is in the market. So we're making $1,700 from trade. So yeah, that wine is definitely a help. Unfortunately, soon we are going to be running out of trade partners, just because right now we are trading primarily with the rest of Bretonnia, and as we confederate with them, there's less and less of the Bretonians to engage with. So unfortunately, it does mean that we need to get as many trade agreements as we can.
Deliver your message.
Not really sure the border princes are gonna. Well, I guess that's the southern realms. It's not really the border princes. Border princes over here. All right. Cool. So let's end the turn and get her close enough to help on the assault. Oh, check diplomacy. Make sure that none of these people.
Mongian, Fei and Chun.
The lady grants you safe path. Welcome to Fair Britonia.
Oh, goddamn, I keep on doing that.
Welcome to Fair Britonia.
As expected. Alright. Oh, that's where the Savage Orcs are. Alright. So yeah, these guys are, you can see the little wheel, means that they're a horde. Nice thing about these guys is that they're like regular orcs, but they have no armor, so they're even easier to kill. they do more attack damage and stuff like that, but it's just funny. They're much, much easier to kill. Are you just a normal, Oh. Alright.
I see my path.
I was gonna say, I thought you were a general. She is a general.
For glory.
There we go.
Ride to glory.
And again, it's just not worth it for me to actually fight this manually. I'm probably gonna they've got some pretty good units in here. Did end up losing two of our men at arms, and we got a banner. It looked like we're gonna raise standard and discipline. Oh, that's actually gonna be really nice. Nice.
Champion of the lady.
All right, and then what we're gonna do is we're gonna take from her. We're just gonna take her stuff. So she's gonna actually give us. Two units. I want to take that guy just because he's ranked up a little bit than one of these men at arms.
My steps are guided.
Perfect. Alright, we're making a good amount of money per turn. So what I am going to do now is I am actually going to go ahead and try and start some rebellions. Unfortunately, we're doing really well in the whole public order scene. So maybe that might be not be an option, but that's fine. I'm not too worried about it. I think we can find stuff to do. If we have to make war with the greenskins or something like that, we can definitely do that. I'm not too worried about it. So I will catch you guys in the next part of this video. It's gonna be kind of broken up again. Hopefully we can get some more confederations going and get Britonia nice and strong. Make Britonia great again. So I'll catch you guys soon. Alright, so in the past couple of turns, some stuff has been going on. First and foremost, I don't remember if these guys have declared war on us before I'd left, but that happened. They haven't been much of a threat. They've been mostly sitting in Caracassone's area. So I haven't really been doing anything with them. We might pursue them later on, but not right now. What did happen was the vampire cunts decided to declare war on the Empire. And, well, being friends and defensive allies with the Empire, I decided to accept for a couple of reasons. Number one, they are way over there. So you can see their closest army is still 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like 6 settlements away from us. They're not an immediate threat. However, like the next turn, Crooked Moon decided that they want to declare war on somebody, one of the Britonian factions, and then we ended up being dragged into war with them because we're allies. So we were now at war with Crooked Moon. And then, like with all within like 3 turns, Caracassone decided to make a confederation with, I think it was Paravon, whoever the faction was right here. Yeah, Paravon, it's right here. So now they have a big area. They just had this raided and razed. We now, Caracassone is a little bit bigger than I thought that, well, not that I thought, than I was expecting them to get. Which might become problematic when it comes time to confederating with them. Because they're so independent, they might not actually want to confederate. Or at least without a little bit of provocation. Mostly from money and gifts and stuff. But that's fine, I can deal with that. So, the problem lies in that the Greenskins, led by, I think, Skarsnik himself, have been making their way over to our friendos in Bastogne. So, given that they are probably coming for Carcassonne, I think it would be a good idea to start sending armies over. Elbric, has come back, and we've given him an army. It's actually, this army right here was at one point, where is he? Was Louis' army, because I just realized this. This one is the one that has the blessing of the lady. It's not, I forgot that we had switched it around. So I actually kicked out, I forget her name, the one that we had hired as an extra army, and I put in Albrecht. So he is now in the lead of our better army with the that little bonus to it. So I think I'm gonna have Albrecht's army come over and deal with the Greenskins, get him a little bit of experience. But I've also started to notice, that the Wood Elves are not too happy about us. We have quite negative relations with all of them. And that's not good if we aren't proactive about that. So I think that after we deal with the Greenskin threat, we might go ahead and purge it completely, because it looks like they own all three of these regions here in the Grey Mountains. We might just go ahead and purge all of that. So, I'm not gonna worry about, the Empire looks like it's doing an alright job. It was a couple turns ago when the Vampire Cunts declared war on us. I think they had Averheim, the Moot, and Grenchstadt, but they don't anymore. So, good stuff. Empire's doing their job. So, we are going to, I think, send Albrecht over for now. I might also send, I did hire a paladin, which is essentially just a single knight who's super strong. I might send him, or this lady with him, along with this guy, who we got from confederating with Lyonnais, I think it was. We might send those two over to also level up a little bit. But I kind of want to keep Louis out of it, just because he's already level 7, and I want to get Albrecht leveled up. Now, the odd thing is that he already has his special weapon. Typically what happens is we have to earn those, but he already has it, so we don't actually have to go out and do the quest battle for this. We just kind of get it. And I'm not sure if that's because this AI picked it up somehow, or if that's just the way it is. But I'm interested to see now. Actually, now that I think about it, I'm interested to see if the Fey Enchantress, I think is her name. No, she doesn't have her item yet. Okay. So it's not just... he must have just picked it up. Okay. Weird. But yeah, he has the Trident of Man. Nifty. So, what do I want? I'll send this people, start to move them over here. Along with this one.
Very well, I go.
Sorceress.
Honor before glory.
I think I'm gonna leave him in Coron. We are starting to lose control here, so when we finally get some negativeness I think it's mostly because of this corruption. It's still hanging around. Once we finally get far enough down, yeah, it's because of the corruption. We'll start getting rebellions, and I think that's what we're gonna farm experience from. So once he's done gaining some more troops, we'll also send him over. I think that we'll have plenty enough. We did get some fire arrows, which are gonna be good against morale. And I kept these guys just because they had a little bit of experience going on. So yeah, got a couple of knights errant, nothing special, basic heavy knights, but they'll do their job. They're anti-infantry, which is gonna be perfect for the greenskins because they don't have a whole lot of monsters. The ones that they do are all right at best. Not a big fan of the orc greenskin roster, and I'm especially not a big fan of Skarsnik's roster. I hated this campaign. I think it's one of the only ones I barely touched. I played a couple of turns and realized I couldn't get orcs and hated it. But that's a talk for a different time if we ever do that. So this is the chick who we had who's not leading an army currently. We'll keep her in reserve just in case later on we need someone. Right now we've just got so many armies. We're already maxed out at peasants. I'm going to be going 2 over with getting Albrecht's army. It's just, we have the money to support more armies, but the peasants are so limiting. And I don't want to have just 50 knights. I mean, we could, if I save up enough money, knights, get some questing knights and knights of the realm. Anti-large, and I'm guessing these ones are anti-infantry. So questing knights, anti-infantry, and the knights of the realm are anti-large. It's kind of nice that they've got both. The other thing is we need to get some technology. Now, seeing as we are going to be eventually going to war with the wood elves, I'm not going to get this right now, but this is definitely going to be something I want to get. What I want to do right now is I want to work my way towards charity. So I think I'm going to go over here to the town census, and as soon as we're ready, or at least a couple turns beforehand, we're going to start to fight the wood elves. We're going to choose that one. So with that, I think we're going to end the turn. Let's see what's up. Oh, we also ranked up in chivalry. I'm not sure when that happened. I didn't see any pop-up come up, but we now can call on the Green Knight once. So if the time comes to need him, I think that we get him for a couple of turns, and then he goes away. Yeah, so basically, we have too many peasants right now. Campaign. Casualty. God, sometimes just reading the descriptions of these is pretty funny. So casualty replenishment or campaign movement. Well, I don't mind having less casualty replenishment. It's only 10%. We're already suffering. I think it's just money. We can live with this one. Burn them. Alright. I'm gonna move him. I think Sarskinik is gonna be up here. See how he wants to go. I'm gonna go right up to our border, and I think I'm gonna recruit a couple more. What I want, since we got a lot of bowmen, I want some more infantry, so I'm gonna do 2 of these guys and 1 of them. That way we've got 3 and 3. That'll be pretty good. You make your way over here as well, and as with you. What can we build? Not much, of course. How much is this? 7,500. We lose so much money from upkeep. I might save up for another turn or two so we can buy something a little bit better. Actually, I think... Oh, it was long. Never mind. Yeah, we'll wait a turn or two.
I see you are true of heart, noble.
The laws of chivalry demand the lady grants you safe passage.
Alright. That's pretty much it for this turn. I think next turn we will be defeating the... Oh no! Oh, interesting. He's going down to us. Perfect. Oh, good. That's exactly what I wanted. Actually, Marienburg is a pretty strong fortress to defend. So I'm not too mad about that. That's... Those silly greenskins. Nordland. Okay. Those silly greenskins could have chosen a much, much more difficult area to attack. I don't want to move them. This guy and the girl and another guy is probably not going to be able to kill all of those greenskins, but honestly, they probably could take on most of them.
Taking my leave.
I'm just going to leave him here. Oh, yeah. I might actually move him. As much as I didn't want to use him and get everyone else leveled up, I might just end up using him to do it. I don't need... What is this? Oh, wow. That's not bad. Once we reach tier 5, there's two buildings I really need to buy. The Abbey and that tournament grounds. Which means I'm actually going to save these two slots. So I'm not going to build anything there. There's really nothing I want to build at the moment, anyways. Okay, I could build a town. Build a town here. This one's probably more important because it's closer to our frontiers, specifically with the scaling up here. And the Norskin tribe, I forget what it's called. They can get pretty nasty. I'd rather have a better garrison here because that's really, really the bonus to that. Okay.
You honor me.
My reputation precedes me.
Alright, I think that's... Oh no, let's check the...
The lady grants you her blessing.
Welcome to fair Britannia. The lady grants you safe
passage.
Yeah, I'd
be really surprised. Because it seems like the only time they really ever want to confederate is when they are losing a war or something like that. So if they happen to lose this army, they might consider a confederation. But until that time... It's pretty low that they're gonna do that. Pretty unlikely. Uh-oh. Actually, I moved him. Yeah, run, Sarsnik. Run like the wind. Oh good, the beastmen were killed. They must have gone down here and killed them. Good for them.
Who calls me hence?
Do you know who I am?
Who wishes the Grail?
No, actually I don't, bud, but good for you.
Protector of the realm.
Yeah. Sarsnik didn't like that. He's running away now. Oh, we can build that Muslan now.
What is your behalf?
Well, with that, I suppose, we do have a good amount of... Oh, I built the last tier, the Bordeaux Wine Market. So yeah, there's that. So we are making a good bit of money. What I think I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna send some of these two who don't have armies right now. I might send them back to Corone and add some knights to them. So they've got a little bit of army. And what I'm gonna do with these guys and you as well, start to make my way over to the Wood Elves. And we're actually going to wait 2 turns, 7 turns. So after this 2 goes, I'm going to get that'll give us a little bit more money, but I'm going to get this, which is going to kill our diplomatic relations with the Wood Elves, but I don't expect after we declare war on one of them that all of them are going to really like me anyways. We will raise their little Wood Elf Arguan, whatever the fuck it's called. Athaloran, that's the one. We'll raise it to the ground. I want to check to see if do they like each other. They're actually at war with each other. Oh, good. So these two are allied, and you like them, but you... Oh no, you're just in defensive lines, okay. Why did I think that they were at war? Somebody at war with each other? They're at war with Crooked Moon. Okay. Well, basically, the only one we can declare war on first is this one. We can raise this. After that, it'd be a good idea to declare war on this guy. That way we can take out these two, and then Mel Gibson we can kill last. He should be alone. I'm not sure, he might end up declaring war on us before then, but because we're killing all of his friends. But that's the goal, at least. Still a few turns off for that. I don't want to get too hyped about it. But that's probably all for this episode. I'll go ahead and do that, get the armies ready. And unless something changes, that's probably what the next episode is going to be, is destroying the Wood Elves and getting that threat out of there before they get too strong, too quickly, too fast, too furious. So I will catch you guys in a little bit.